This is an original wood engraving from 1877, which shows Queen Victoria and the royal family. We restored this piece at Posterfix. Hi, I'm Chris. Today we have a very special wood engraving by Matthew White Ridley, who was born in 1837 and died in 1888. He did a fantastic engraving showing Queen Victoria and her family. An 1870s group portrait. Queen Victoria is in the center with her 9 children, 4 sons and 5 daughters, 2 daughters-in-law, 4 sons-in-law, and 23 grandchildren. This piece was creased and stained. We bleached it, we linen-backed it, and we restored it. And you're going to see that now.
It's folded, and it's a bit stained, as seen on the back. Let's see. This side looks pretty good. And the poster paper is slightly brown, but not too bad. The paper probably is acidic, but it's in better condition than I've seen for other posters of this age. Because of the browning of the paper, I want to bleach it. I'm adding bleach to this water.
The paper is in pretty good condition considering it's from 1877. I'm going to bleach this. I'm going to put it in a mild bleach bath to see if we can even out the tone and get rid of those obvious stains before they begin to create mold. Once I have this piece in the bleach bath, I need to keep an eye on it, monitor it every 5 or 10 minutes to see how it's progressing. Some pieces bleach faster than others, and you just have to watch it to see how it's reacting. May I help you? You say you have a vintage poster you'd like to have poster fixed? Put on a linen backing. Yes, we've been doing it for 33 years in Brooklyn, USA. We're in the Brooklyn Navy Yard. What sort of poster is it? A French poster from the 1890s? La Belle Époque? Bonnard? Oh, he's a great one. His posters fetch a lot of money. Yes, I know that poster. I've done it before. It's been a long time. What's its condition? Okay, well, it sounds like it's got some issues. Why don't you send me some photos? Can you do that? Can you email me a few photos of it so I can see? That would be great. Chris@posterfix.com. And then I'll look it over and give you some recommendations of what we can do to conserve it. Alrighty? Yes, actually right now I'm working on a Toulouse-Lautrec Divan Japanese poster. Yeah. I know, I saw it went for $20,000 in one auction, $24,000 in another. Yeah, alright, I look forward to seeing your pictures. Thanks. Okay, let's see how it's going now. Much better, much better. It looks like it's brightened up. I'm going to have to take it out of the bleach bath and dry it off to really know how it looks because the paper's wet. And if I leave it wet, I don't get a real accurate sense as to how much it brightened up. But I expect it's brightened up enough.
It seems to have brightened up quite a lot. We'll know better after it dries, because now the paper's wet and it's not giving me a real accurate sense of color. So Once this piece dries, we'll get a better sense. But looking at it, I can see the areas that were stained really absorbed the bleach. And I suspect it'll dry well because it looks brighter even wet. So we'll let it dry overnight and linen back it tomorrow. It's now the next morning and the poster is dry and the poster is bright and there are no stains on Queen Victoria's family whatsoever, except maybe for Prince Andrew.
Matthew White Ridley was a painter and etcher. He married and had a daughter, Dorothy Ridley. Matthew White Ridley first met James McNeill Whistler in Paris in 1856 and later became a regular member of his circle in London. I'm putting wheat paste onto the acid-free paper. The wheat paste is a special grade that has an acid-neutralizing agent added to it. Once I've applied the wheat paste to the paper, I will lay down the print to that. Linen backing is a process where we can take your print, your engraving, your poster, your lithograph, whatever it is, and mount it to a piece of acid-free paper and cotton canvas. This has the benefit of extending the life of the print because it makes it sturdier and helps it weather the deterioration of acid, which will make it weak and impossible to display. So, of all the mounting processes that exist in the world, linen backing is the only one that really doesn't harm the paper as far as its molecular construction is concerned. It helps to enhance the value of the poster too and makes it ready for reselling, collecting, display, whatever you want to do with it. This engraving of Her Majesty Queen Victoria and the Royal Family by Sir Matthew White Ridley was published in 1877. Queen Victoria's son and heir, the future Edward VII, stands behind her, with his eldest son and wife to his left. The future George V is at lower right. The heir to the German throne, the future Frederick III, is seated at left. At top left, the eldest grandchild is the future German Kaiser Wilhelm II. At far right, peering from behind her mother's shoulder, is the future Alexandra Fyodorovna, Empress of Russia. Sorry about that. This etching by Ridley was published on the 14th of July, 1877, in Frank Leslie's Illustrated Newspaper. Right now you're seeing me roll out the poster. I'm pushing out the excess wheat paste, and more importantly, I'm pushing out the excessive air pockets, or any air pockets that are in there. We don't want it to dry with air pockets. And then after I finish rolling it out, I go over it with sponges and wash off any residual wheat paste which is still on the face of this print. Wood engraving from England. But there we are. The print is now linen-backed. Her Majesty has been preserved. Good show! We're going to let this poster dry for a few days before we commence with the restoration.
Now Queen Victoria is dry and we're going to go in there and start the restoration, burnishing it and doing some light cleaning and touch-up here and there.
Queen Victoria had given birth to 9 little miracles of life by the time her beloved cousin, husband, Albert, died in 1861. That's a lot of birthdays to remember. That's a lot of royal indoor soccer games to attend. That is, in general, just a lot. Remarkably, every single one of the couple's progeny managed to make it to adulthood. It's what happened next that wasn't always great news. We're going to let this print dry for a few days before we cut it down. Oki is using paper pulp to fill in the small bits of missing paper around the edges of the poster. After the paper pulp has dried, she sands it down. Now I am trimming it down and leaving about 1 inch of extra backing border around the print. This allows the framer some extra border to work with when he's making a frame in case he needs overlap. He can trim it down to what he needs. Another reason is that dealers and collectors like to have fat borders so that they can handle the poster before it gets framed without leaving their thumbprints on the poster itself. Anybody who's ever been to a poster fair or a print fair knows what I'm talking about. I'm taking a very fine grade of sandpaper and sanding the margins where the paper pulp was put in to even it out, to make it smooth. I'm also using the fine sandpaper as an aggressive eraser because there's some pencil marks here in the margin that I need to erase and they don't want to come out. We are burnishing. This is a way of flattening out the ridges and creases in the paper and must be done before we touch it up.
One of the things that makes
this print different from other things that I restore is that it's an engraving. An engraving, the wood engraving and the steel engraving, it's a lost art. Engravers who interpret an image into an engraving so that it can be printed had a very awesome talent. They would use very small pinpoint tools to scrape into a plate lines that would render the image so that when you look at the image, it looked like it's tonal. If you've ever looked at a $1 bill, the face of George Washington is a steel engraving. So I'm going to be touching it up with that in mind. I have to go into this and put in lines and marks that will fit in to the engraving pattern, the lines in the print. I need to be respectful of those lines as though they were brush strokes. I'm using watercolor pencils and markers, which are water reversible. Jolly good. And there you have it. Another vintage piece of paper from long ago, restored, brought back to life by Poster Fix. This is Chris. After 33 years of restoring vintage paper, I can still say I look forward to seeing what you're going to send me. Thank you very much.